Hello and welcome back to Mama Eurovision. My name is Julia Divina. I am your Mama Eurovision.
And I am Aura Jennifer, your Teddy Eurovision.
Here we are reacting for the very first time to all of the songs competing at the grand final of the Eurovision Song Contest 2024. This time is Germany.
Deutschland.
Hello. I've been living in Berlin for almost 10 years now. I am really, really thankful for the opportunities and gorgeous community I have here in Berlin. And I promise to not be biased and real regardless of my visa status.
No, we have to be extra real for that world.
Aber natürlich so. So let's just get into business. Germany has been not doing well for a long while in Eurovision, whether it's for the lack of vision or for the lack
of vision.
And we're very hoping that this year it's going to be any kind different. Isaac is going to sing Always on the Run for Germany, and let's get into business and press play. Teddy, you ready?
Yes, that's great. Ready. Let's do it.
Mm-hmm. Great voice, great. I can already say. Oh!
But she's also giving me Pedestrian a little bit. Oh, that voice.
The voice is voicing.
The voice is voicing. Building up. Is the song strong?
Wait, what? I didn't see this drop coming.
Me neither, but is the song songing?
This song has a potential to be songing. It's just very Swedish-American, and this have like Disney kind of Lion King edges to it.
It could be Zlata Ognevich from Ukraine back in the day.
Yeah, but that's not Ukraine, that's his Deutschland.
That's his Deutschland, that's...
His voice is phenomenal though.
Yeah.
And she sings live. She knows how to sing live.
Do you think they did the Pedestrian style on purpose? So the voice is more standing out because of that, the effect? Or why did she choose those clothes?
Well, you'll have to ask her. I'm kind of confused right now with where is it going? Because it becomes a very middle of the way, something that was like leftovers of Melodifestivalen. Oops, I said it.
But I also heard much more mediocre songs this year, I have to say. And it's really the voice that stands out.
Who are you fighting for? That's a good question.
We don't know. Tell us.
The voice is phenomenal. He is great.
Yeah.
So this song is a...
I see what you're seeing. I hear what you're hearing. But you know, with the right set design, which this is not, I think this could go far. Because it really lives from emotions and from the voice, and he's bringing it in that department. Bravo, Germany. I'm kind of pleasantly surprised, I have to honestly
say. Yeah, when you have no expectations,
but
there is
the
no...
other part of the...
No, it's not bad again, but there is... We said it many times, you said it many times, you either be glorious or flop at all. And this is too safe, it's too middle of the way. The staging is, dare I say, boring. I don't find myself very often listening to Eurovision sound and checking how long has it been and how long do we have left. Because after a minute and a half, I felt like, okay, got it. What's next?
That's not a good sign.
And that has nothing to do, that's not a testimony on his talent, because he is very talented and the voice is phenomenal and the song does portray lots of emotions, which might go well. but this needs a complete revamp, pre-staging, strip it open, dress it again. Teddy, what do you think?
I think it's a good song. A good song, not an outstanding song by any means. It's an outstanding voice. It's an outstanding emotion that he's able to convey. But I also agree with you that there is a lack of something special, you know?
Wings. I need wings.
I need wings. I need wings.
Not like the literal wing, but I need wings so I can fly on it.
Well, I need literal wings.
We've seen where that brought Norway in 2021.
That is also true. But we also saw where it brought Azerbaijan.
Where?
Back in the day.
Where?
It was the 7th place or 8th, I don't remember.
Where?
Belgrade.
Where?
Serbia.
Where? JK, how many points would you give Germany, Teddy?
I'm giving Isaac good 6 points.
Good six points from Teddy Eurovision. Confident 6 points. And I'm sorry, Tutme lied. For me, it would be strong 4 points. And all of them are going to you. All of them are going to the performer and to their beautiful voice. Together it's a 10.
It's a 10.
Together it's a 10. That's good news. Please let us know in the comments, how do you feel about the German entry? Is there any chance Germany will be back at the top of the Eurovision chart? Or is another year of Nullpoint? I don't think that's a Nullpoint material.
No,
but it's definitely not going to be high, unfortunately. Next year, come to Berlin, hunt some of our gorgeous queer musician friends. Let them go to Eurovision and we'll bring you a victory. That being said, thank you for joining us. My name is Judy Ledivina. I am your mommy Eurovision.
And I'm Aura Jen LeFak, your Teddy Eurovision.
And you let us know who you are in the comments as you tell us what you think about the German entry.